The stock market is crashing. Cue the fire. Sell everything. And I have, look, I have your portfolio. Your broker actually sent it to me. Hold on. That's your current position down. And there's only one thing that goes down in the Bravo family, and that would be my wife. My wife's dog. When he jumps up on the bed, I'm like, get down. Actually, we have a hate relationship between her dog, right? Because you know how you are on the ranking of dog, kids, husband. And just so I always have a good relationship with my wife, when she leaves, I play with her dog. I'm like, okay, let's play Chew Mama's Slipper. But then I kind of have to hide him. And then she finds him later. She's like, oh my gosh. I'm like, I know, he's a terrible dog. Also, Goldman Sachs in fourth quarter, which was good, remember fourth quarter? They lost almost $500 million, or they lost $500 million in stock trading. So if you think your trades are bad, they have you beat when they should not have been down. But Goldman got clobbered like baby seals in a bathtub, like the stuffed animal ones, not the real ones. And then you dip buyers are like, yes, buy the dip, buy the dip. And you just wait until Friday when options expire. You think this was a dip? Oh, there's more chips and dip a-coming. Oh, and the bond market got slaughtered today. Even the Fed was like, I'm not touching those things. Those are disgusting. Well, Jerome, have you looked at your balance sheet lately? And they say it's technical issues. You're in charge of this thing. Let me help you out, Jerome. Pretend this is your computer and that's you click it. You just click the buy button. It works every time. Also, if you could do me a huge favor just to save the channel, click that. Hopefully it'll save it. And because I do all this work for you, I'm like, look over here. The Fed Reserve is in deep trouble over disaster balance sheet. That's what Dick says. So whatever Dick says, you do. Well, actually, scratch that. He's not telling you to do anything. Like, for me, it's always told me what to do since I was a small child. Actually, more so puberty. I'm like, what are we doing today? I can't think. And Maggie and Fred were working their butts off today. Dow comes off. They keep having to change this. Dow comes off the lows of the day drop, 900 point. No, wait. Maggie, scratch. Hold on. Scratch that. Let's change this. Wait, it's no longer at 900. It's at 700, Maggie? Okay, good. We're good. No? No, we lost the 700. We're at 4. Okay. Woof. 400. Thank you. Thank you, retail. Thank you, plunge protection team. All of those, we would just like to say thank you. And all because of Goldman Sachs. Dow falls sharply as rates rise. Goldman disappoints on earnings. Yeah, because we found out how much you lost in trading on the fourth quarter, you idiots. And also talking about Goldman Sachs, gold is good, but silver performed very well today. If I can remember in my little brain, I will. But just congratulations to you silver stackers. Today was a good day. The whole market went to hell in a handbasket. Goldman shares ticked more than 7% lower on Tuesday. I don't know if they had to rewrite that. I don't know how low the Sachs went. Bank missed analysts' expectations, because that's why they're analysts, for the fourth quarter earnings. Now, I want to talk about this. Goldman's operating expense surged to 23%. What? On increased pay for Wall Street employees, just like what happened in 1929, 1930, 1931. Remember the Great Depression? Actually, incomes rose about 16%, which when the analysts go back, they're like, how is this? The Great Depression, like the market sold off 100%. Everyone was like, oh, thank you, kind sir. Can I have a piece of bread? How is it that people were making 16% more money? Well, welcome to the Great Depression, now you know. But here we go, stock sell-off, gather paces, bond yields climb. Yikes, you do not want those yields climbing because then everyone has to pay their debt back that they just took out a whole lot at a higher rate. And it is all red above my head. Peloton got a beat down too. Not too good. Netflix, Lyft, these are all like all the tubers. That's what all the YouTubers were talking about. I remember that. Tesla, Friday, Tesla. Uber got a beatdown of almost 7% today. Robin to Hood, it's at 14 bucks now. Oh my gosh, buy the dip. GME and their diamond hands. Goldman Sachs should have went silver. I'm just saying. And let me just do some crayon TA for you. The first level was there, right? Yeah, I missed it. The second level, this is called support. Yep, you found it. Your next one, according to my crayons, is right there. So let's see if tomorrow we get a little bit of a bump and then come on down to there. There we go. And this is when everyone tomorrow is like, oh, ha, you said Goldman was going to sell off. Look, it's up today. It's up 1%. Ha, ha, ha. You don't know. It's like a cat falling out of a tree, hitting limbs on the way down. You're like, look, it's holding. Hang in there, buddy. It's only Tuesday. You got plenty of room to the downside and nine lives. You'll be fine. But the big moves that control the whole market, that 10-year yield, 30-year yield, TLT, and DXY, that's why I have them on the top. And hopefully you guys are not a bond channel, right? I mean, just at the get-go, you're like, that'd be very boring. Actually, the three things that I would never want to be in my life, bond market channel, an English teacher, or a math teacher. And honestly, one of my first jobs in the was junior high. They're like, you're going to be the math teacher. And I was like, I know I have a master's degree, but let's just set that aside. I can't even count. And if you remove my fingers, I am totally lost. But I am not lost on charts. And look at that, ET phone home. That thing is moving. Woo! Where, oh, where will it find support? Well, definitely you're under the 200-day. You broke my trend line. I'll see you down there. See the green line? Yeah, I drew that a long time ago. And also, I rarely trade bonds. That would be Stephen Van Meter's job. But I'm gonna help you with this. That's your top. We'll just say that's the top of the head. Pretty wonky, and I shouldn't even be doing it on the line chart. But I'm gonna help you do the measured move here. You got the head and shoulders there. It's weak, but it's there. Let me help you on the measured move. Give me one more second. I also have a course on it. I have two of them. Link in the description. Oh, hey, look. Looky there, you broke the neckline. I wonder why I have that green line there. It's just not there yet. Just give it time. Just no one tell Stephen Van Meter that. For those of you who are like, who's that guy? He's the Bond King, a good friend of mine. I knew him at 4,000 subscribers, almost at that 100,000 mark, which I'm sure when he gets there, YouTube will send him a plaque like everyone else. I'm the only one that's never gotten anything. Also, if you're interested in learning how to trade that stuff, it's that one. That's the measured moves and things. Crypto Stocks University. Dominate stocks is swing trading. That's easy. If you're like, I don't know what I'm doing, do that one. After you get that one, 6 months, move over to that one. And prices have been going up, but it is not 1,000 yet. It will. Actually, it probably won't, because I'll always feel real guilty. I like to sell. I'm a terrible salesperson. Don't ever hire me. I'll be like, here, selling cars. I'm like, here's invoice. Just do $100 over. But onto the 10-year yield. You want to know where support is? Yep, and we're way above it. So it's like GME back in the day. That's our 10-year bond yield, which if you ever want to know, like prices of cars, prices of houses, it usually reflects on the 10-year. So if you're thinking about buying a house, you may want to wait until rates are really high. Then your mortgage payment is very extreme. Also, it looks like people are piling back into the dollar. Oh, I'm scared. Where do we go? Go to the dollar. And the dollar is like that love-hate relationship, but it's the hate-hate relationship. I don't think anyone likes the dollar, but it's basically the only tool in the shed, and it's not even sharp, and it's going to go to zero. Well, it kind of already did, but whatever. It's just bouncing around in the zeros. But then people are like, well, just go Bitcoin. Like, I'm like, okay, the only problem is, you know, you're up, you're down, you're up, you're down. But then people are like, but that's why we hodl. But I'm like, if I want to buy stuff in the market, and you're like, go all in. Okay, 70,000, 69. Bitcoin trolled you, top, 69. Okay, here it all is. Now you're like, It's at 40 now. I'm like, well, I wanted to buy that boat. Well, you have to wait. Bravo, you got to wait until the next bull run. How long is that? Well, it's 4 years. Well, I wanted to buy a boat. But Bravo, a boat's a terrible investment. You should own silver. I'm like, okay. But every time I try to like fish off of it, I sink. But even hedge funds are dumping tech. No, wait till Friday. Hold on, you got to hold for that story. Buying oil in search for return. Should we be going all in on oil now? And hedge funds are usually a dollar late and a dollar dumb. They're always behind the curve. So if they're all going all in on oil right now, you should probably be taking profit. Here, I will show you and turn some indicators on just for you. You come over here to futures. You click on futures, gold, flat, 1,800. Congratulations. Peter Schiff may have his day. Silver up 3%. Good job, you stackers. I just cannot. I can't surf on the thing. I can't boat on the thing. Crude oil. Here we go. And if you are in my crypto stock, CSU, the university one, you'll know right by looking at that, that you're like, that's a rising wedge. And I will say you are correct. That's not only a rising wedge. That is a rising wedge that goes, hey, let's have another rising wedge, which it's actually even stronger. And you had a bearish head and shoulders pattern. Didn't play out. Not valid. It's unvalidated. Get rid, hit delete. You come over here, you click on that button. You're like, poof, gone. Some of you guys are like, what about oil? What about oil? Okay, so yeah. So we got above that. What you want to do is come down, retest, and then keep going. Also, did I tell you this is not financial advice? We only paper trade on this channel. You are getting really close to that little section. That is your, see this? That's your take profit zone. Then it turns into the sell button, right? And it goes down. And then you have a buy button, and then it rips up, and then you sell, and you just keep making money. And yes, all of this is in my courses. Just paper trade, though. Don't want you to lose any money. But okay, let's head to Friday. Some of the options channels that I follow. We're talking. We're in it. We're rowing. And they're saying Friday, we have $125 billion. I highlighted it for you, unless you're audio listening to me. I don't know. This channel would be very boring audio-wise. Our base case is that the expiration of these deep-in-the-money calls are a catalyst for volatility. Watch that VIX. Now, here it is. This is the sentence we've all been waiting for. That is expanded stock price movement higher or lower. So it's going to go one way or the other. And if you want to know where all the options contracts are, Apple, Microsoft, Amazon, Tesla, Facebook, and Google, which looks a lot like this ETF right there, ARK. Hey, I know you, Kathy. I think she has had an underwhelming performance this year and last year. And wow, just when you thought it couldn't go any lower, that MACD is telling you, yeah, you're going lower there, Kathy. My apologies for that. You should probably do these little lines thing. It'll kind of tell you which way it goes. Let me clean up Lux Algo a little bit for you. Wow, you were all the way up there? That was crazy. $160 all the way down to, ooh, 70. Oh, Bravo, you said that the stock market was gonna crash. Well, I mean, you hold an ARK? Like what I've always said, what goes up must come down. And Kathy's ARK Wood, Kathy Wood, I always say Woods. That's not a kind of ARK. And I'd say you got some holes in your wood. You probably need some duct tape. And I guess as the Fed today was watching the bond market sell off, they're like, oh, due to technical difficulties, we can't touch that stuff anymore. And I'd say, well, Jerome, you have a whole lot of it on your balance sheet, my friend. Just looking. Also, there is a crazy correlation between the Fed's balance sheet, you know, putting little numbers in and buying bonds. A lot to do with equities, you know, the things like Tesla. Yeah, those are equities. And let me just show you here. I'll draw this. Sometimes I do this. Here's the stock market following along with the bond market. Oh, you stopped. You stop buying them, okay, bounce off Bravo's head a few times and head on down. And like what I said earlier, Dick says the Federal Reserve is in deep trouble. Ooh, what are they going to do? They have a disaster balance sheet. Well, yes. And here he is. Here's Dick. Let's listen to Dick. And he has a lot of books. So let me fast forward to, let's see, what's Dick saying?
Well, basically the problem is that the good times are over for Goldman Sachs for this year, and also for JP Morgan and Morgan Stanley and all of the companies that are in the capital markets arena. The Federal Reserve's balance sheet is a total mess, one of the worst positions that I've ever seen it. And basically, it's going to have to cut the size of that balance sheet. And when it does so, it's going to slow down the growth of money. And
well, that's not good. Then it's going to crash our market, Dick. Without money, Dick, we have the liquidity. We need that. So get on the phone with Jerome and tell him this disaster of a balance sheet. I wish I could have that, right? I could just sit there at my computer and go like, I think I want more money. That'd be great. But like always, you guys, stay safe. Learn how to trade. Do not be the bag holders at the top, even though YouTubers tell you, please, markets only go up. Without that liquidity, markets does go up. But you will soon find out. But that is okay, and I will see you tomorrow.